Hi, I'm Agent Bennett, and today I'm going to show you how to set up Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, or DHCP Reservations. Here's what you'll need: a network router or mesh system already set up, the IP address and login credentials for your router's management portal, devices already connected to that network, a computer or mobile device like a tablet or smartphone. I'll be using a Netgear RAX70 router, an HP laptop, and an HP network-capable printer. So the steps might be a little different depending on your devices. So when do you want to make a DHCP reservation? Well, anytime a device on your network needs the same IP address from your router. For example, if you have a printer that's used by multiple computers, it would be a good idea to set a DHCP reservation. That way, the IP address of the printer will always be the same, making it easier for the computers and the printer to communicate. Or if you have a smart home device that needs to maintain consistent communication with other devices in an ecosystem. For example, if you have Philips Hue bridges, Samsung SmartThings hubs, and Lutron Caseta bridges. These devices communicate with smart home devices, and having set IP addresses for each makes that process easier and more consistent. DHCP reservation is different than static IPs. You set static IPs on things that are critical or need to be available all the time. That way, if for some reason the DHCP server isn't working, devices with a static IP address can still be reached. For example, if you have security cameras that record to a DVR, they'll still be able to reach each other even if your DHCP server goes down. Also, you would want to assign a static IP to a server that's hosting file shares or other services. Likewise, you would want it on network-attached storage, also known as NAS, or if you have a DVR system with security cameras. That's because if the DHCP server isn't functioning properly, you could still reach these devices on your network through a static IP that was programmed into the device. All right, now that you know when to make a DHCP reservation, let me show you how it's done. I'll be assigning an IP address reservation for this printer. First, make sure the device is powered on and connected to the network. Then, on your computer, open a web browser and enter the IP address for your router's management portal. Using your login credentials, sign into the router. Click the Advanced tab. Then click Setup. And then LAN Setup. On the right, scroll down to the Address Reservation section and click Add. In the Address Reservation table, find the device needing a reserved address and click the radio button next to it. This will populate the IP address and MAC address fields. Now click Add. You can keep the current one that's been automatically assigned, or you can enter your own. Just make sure it's not already assigned to another device on your network. You can check the IP addresses under the Address Reservation section of the LAN Setup page. It looks like this. To edit or delete a reservation, click the radio button next to the device and then click either Edit or Delete. It's that simple. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, give it a like. If you have questions, leave them in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more tech tips from Best Buy. Thanks for watching!